Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see the details on Sling Feature Flags in AEM. How to use Sling Feature Flags in AEM to enable the continuous integration. Feature flags are used to select whether a particular feature is enabled or not in the application. This allows us to continuously deploy new features of an application without making them globally available yet. The new features can be controlled through feature flags to be available only to the specific set of users. So this will help us to enable continuous integration without impacting the global platform. So the same feature, we can control the same features, whether it's going to be available for all the users or specific set of users through this feature flags. Sling feature flag support consists of two parts. The first one is the feature flag itself, represented by the feature interface. And the second one is the application providing a feature guarded by the feature flag. A feature flag is simply a Boolean condition that modifies the behavior of a component, module, or function in your application. Features may be enabled based on various contextual data. Some of them are time of the day, segmentation data, gender, age, etc. If it is available, request parameters, request headers, cookie value, static, also like can be enabled through static configuration also. Feature flags can be provided by registering this service like org, apache, sling, feature flags.feature. Your feature service can implement this specific interface, or even you can enable the feature flags through the OSJ configuration with this specific factory ID, org, apache, sling, feature flags dot IMBL dot configured feature. Let us now see how to enable a feature service. Okay, so this is my sample feature service. This feature service is implementing this feature. So as already we discussed, this is one of the option to enable the features. So here there is a method called isEnabled. Yeah, add the required logic to enable or disable the feature into this specific method, isEnabled method. So this will return a Boolean value, true or false. True means the feature is enabled. False means the feature is disabled. The execution context interface, whatever is here, provides access to the context for evaluating whether a feature is enabled or not. This will provide all your context data, means your request, your headers, even your resource details, all those context data will be provided through this execution context. Also, you should provide a description and name so that you can uniquely identify your features through the console. This is the name you will be using to refer the specific features whenever you want to use it in your application. So this is the dynamic configuration. So means like based on this implementation logic, the feature status is returned, either true or false. In my case, the feature flag is enabled based on the query parameter named new total. If the value of the query parameter is true, then the flag is enabled. If not, the flag is disabled. You should be able to implement your own logic based on different context data, either through the request parameter, cookie value, or resource data, or anything. Now, yeah, this feature is ready now. So it's a very simple feature. So now let's enable a servlet. So that's going to be guarded by this feature flag. Now, this is my servlet. So it's a normal servlet, path-based for now, for a demo. Now, if you see here, you can get the reference of features through this specific line. You can reference these features. It will give all the list of features. The servlet calculates the total based on the input parameters. If you see something like quantity and value. Now we need to implement the new calculation logic for specific users. So the new logic consider the tax value also to calculate the total. The specific logic is the old or new logic is selected based on the feature flag value. If you see here, we are putting a condition here. Features dot is enabled. The specific feature name, calculate new total feature, that's what we defined here earlier. Now if this feature is enabled, the new calculation total is selected.
If not, the old logic will be selected. The feature flag is enabled if the request has the new total parameters with the value true. If the new total parameter is true, the new logic is selected, or the old logic. Means the new logic is enabled only to the users, since the new total parameter as true. For all other users, the old logic is selected. Using this, you will be able to enable new features without enable and test the new features without impacting all the users.
Yeah, now the feature flag and the servlet is ready, so we can deploy and test it. So I already deployed, so let me go and test it. So I am going to test with two scenarios. One is like new total true, I'm passing all the parameter. This is just for a demo. A real case scenario will be different. I am going and executing this. If you see here, total is 60. Why? Means like I am passing this new total equal to true. If I go and pass this new total equal to false, it's obviously going to send 6, because the feature flag is not enabled. So it's using the old logic, the total calculation logic. Okay, so like this, through this feature interface, by implementing the feature interface, you should be able to define your own feature flag. So like this, so yeah, then you can add your own logic here. So let us now see how to enable the feature flag through OSJ config. So the same the feature flag can be enabled through OSJ config also, but it is little different. I will explain what is different. Yeah, I already enabled that. Let me show you. So it's in here. Okay, if you see here, like I just enabled a run mode specific OSA config. So org.apache.sling.featureflags.imbl configured feature. So just appended a name, because my feature name is simple sample feature. It's a factory ID, the configured feature. So you can create multiple features. So now if you go here some values are there, like name, so sample feature. It's the same thing, whatever we did it in the interface. This is going to be used to identify the feature, then obviously description, then enabled true or false. So you can keep whatever the value you want. Yeah, so once ready, like once you deploy, obviously, like if I go to CRXTE, you can see that particular configuration here, config. Yeah, so same thing, no difference. So one difference is this is going to be a static configuration. So whatever we seen earlier, enabling through the interface, the feature interface, that's a dynamic configuration, but this is going to be a static configuration. As you have seen this, so the flag value set in this configuration itself, so it's going to be true or false. There is no logic to derive this flag. It's a static configuration, but it's like same, this static feature flag also can be used in the application as same as the dynamic feature flags to guard the features. So also, like that same configuration can be created or modified and also verified through OSJ console. But anyway, obviously creation and modification through OSJ console is not recommended. The run mode specific OSJ config, whatever I shown you, that's one recommended. So but still I will show you. So if I go here, so if you see here, there is a factory configuration called Apache Sling configured feature. So I already, so whatever I deployed, this is the one configuration, sample feature. If I open this, so yeah, you can have a name, description, and enable true or false. If you want, you can add the new configuration. If I go here, so if you see here, this is the factory ID, configured feature. You can define multiple features, feature flags. Okay, now like we can like see all these feature flags, whatever we defined. So far we defined two feature flags. One is the calculation total feature flag, that's a dynamic feature flag. Then another one is the static feature flag with the name sample feature. So all those feature flags and also the existing system feature flags, you can see it from here, Sling features. So it will display all of the features, like our custom features. This is our dynamic custom feature. Also, these are all the existing AEM platform specific features. Also, the static feature, like if I go and sample feature, this is the static feature. Yeah, if you see here, like this value is showing as false by default. Why? Because this feature is based on the request parameter. So only when that specific request parameter is there, so this feature status will become true. Okay, let us now see now we have seen how to define a feature flag. Either it can be static or dynamic. So then, and using that flag to guard our feature in the application. Now let's see how to use the same feature flag in Granite render conditions to show or hide Granite UI fields. So render condition, you all already might be knowing. Render condition is a mechanic to indicate if the component should be rendered or not. The feature flags can be used with render conditions to show or hide UI fields. So let me show you what I am referring. So let me open the dialog. This is my sample page. Yeah, see in this dialog, in this basic tab, I have a field with the name additional comments. So I want to display the additional comments dialog field based on my feature flag. Like the static feature flag, whatever I defined, the sample feature, display the field if the feature flag is enabled and hide if disabled. Yeah, for that, so what you need to do is you need to define a render condition. So this is my dialog. If I go to this page, component, then tabs, items, basic, items, then column. Yeah, additional comments, this is my field, so it's of text field. Now if you see here, you to hide or so based on the render condition, you should be using this Granite render condition. So the render condition will support multiple resource types, but for now what we are doing is we are going with a feature render condition. So what this will do is it will give you the support to use the feature flag. So yeah, Granite render condition, then resource type, this is the resource type, then feature, like what is the feature name. I'm going and telling the sample feature, that is my flag name, the static flag name. So based on the outcome or the flag status, true or false, that particular allow comments field will be displayed. Okay, let's see now. Now if I go to this flag, I will go back here. Okay, sample feature. Now if I see, yeah, it's enabled. That's the reason you are seeing that additional comments field here. Now let me go and disable this. Okay, now let us go and test it again. If I come down, you can see that field is not displayed. Why? Because the feature flag, this field is rendered based on the feature render condition. For that specific feature flag status is now false. So the field is not rendered. So you can use it, you can use the dynamic feature flag here. So based on some logic, you can hide the field. So let's say you want to hide based on the user access, you can still do it. Whatever you want to achieve, you should be able to do it. Let us now see another scenario of using this feature flags. The feature flags can also be used to trigger the workflow launches along with the other conditions. So you already aware of the workflow launches. So you can define some conditions and detail based on those conditions, the workflow will be triggered. So that's called the workflow launches. So obviously even you can use the features flag, the feature flags to trigger the workflows. So let me show you that. Okay, I have a custom workflow, something DAM update asset. So I defined a launcher here, workflow launcher. Let me edit that, go into properties. Yeah, so obviously you can see what is the event type, what is the node type, then path, then run modes. Even if you can add some additional conditions based on the metadata. So here you can see two drop down fields. One is features, one is disabled features. So the features means add the list of features that must be enabled to trigger the launcher. So if you are selecting some features, list of features here, it will list out all the available features. Then those all features should be enabled to trigger this launcher with this additional condition. So all other additional conditions should be met, and also the features selected within this from this list should be enabled. Now if you see the disabled feature, it is in other way. So the list of features what you are selecting must be disabled to trigger the launcher. So you can select multiple features, so but all the features should be disabled trigger this launcher. Now what I am going to do is my interest is like I am selecting this feature, sample feature, whatever I define. So only this workflow should be triggered when this sample feature flag is enabled. So if it is true, this launcher should be triggered, otherwise it should not be. Now let me go back. If I go to sample, now it should be disabled. Yeah, it's a disabled. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to maybe upload a PDF. Okay. Yeah, files. Yeah, let me upload some sample PDF. Okay, now let me go to maybe the workflow of instance console, archive console. Yeah, I'm not seeing any item. So means the workflow is not triggered. So now what I will go back and do is I will enable this feature. So I will go and say enable this. So meanwhile, let me delete this so that I can upload the same one again. Okay, it's done. Now this fine. Now what I'm going and doing is again I'm uploading the same file. Okay, upload. And now let me go back and see here. This time the instance would be created. Yeah, if you see here, now the instance is created. It means the launcher triggered the workflow. So that's why you are seeing this instance. So you can control this through this feature flag, whether the launcher should be triggered or not. Yeah, the Sling feature flags can be used in AEM to manage the features externally from the application code. So like most of the like easy option is like you can put a if and if else condition in the code, but that's going to create a problem in the future. But this through this feature flags, you can manage your features externally from the application code. Also, the flags can be dynamic based on the implementation logic or can be a static. The features can be enabled based on different context data, example, request parameters, cookies, resource properties, etc. The feature flags helps us to continuously deliver features without impacting the end users. Also helps to dry run the new features without enabling to public users. Yeah, that's all for today. Yeah, that covers the options to create the features, the dynamic and static, and how we can use that features flags in application to guard the feature. Then second one is how we can use the feature in the render condition to hide or show the granite UI fields. Then last one is how we can use the features in workflow launches to trigger the launches based on the feature flag status. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.